Welcome back to Coogan's Critters. Today, we will be discussing aquaculture. What is aquaculture? Well, we generally take agriculture to mean industry surrounding livestock and farming. Aquaculture is much like this, but as the aqua suggests, in water. Specifically, aquaculture is defined as the cultivation of aquatic animals and plants, especially fish, shellfish, and seaweed, in natural or controlled marine or freshwater environments, or underwater agriculture. In aquaculture, you often work with aquatic species, species that live in the water for the majority or all of their life. Some examples of aquatic species include fish, seaweed, crustaceans, and shellfish. While it is important to know a lot about many different aquatic species and know much about them, for the purposes of the video, we are going to do a brief overview of some of these aquatic species, including a physical description, terminology, reproduction methods, and uses. Fish are cold-blooded, with fins, gills, scales, and a backbone. They also lay eggs. While fish have no gender-specific terminology, baby fish are called fry. Fishes can be used for food, oil, etc. Seaweed, also known as macroalgae, is a green plant that may be considered slimy and can be eaten. It can be used for fertilizer, chemicals, cosmetics, and food. Who doesn't love sushi? Seaweed can reproduce sexually or asexually. For more information on sexual and asexual
reproduction, see our Growth and Development of Organisms science video. Crustaceans, such as crabs or krill, have a hard exoskeleton or shell and may have antennas. Reproduction method depends here on the breed, but most reproduce sexually or lay eggs. Crustaceans can be eaten and are also essential to the food chain, especially plankton and organisms like that. Shellfish, such as oysters, have an exoskeleton and are interesting in that some change sex. Oysters are born with eggs and sperm. They are a food source, though many humans are allergic. Speaking of food, health and nutrition is a key component of aquaculture. All aquatic species should have a diet with sufficient nutrients, amino acids, vitamins, minerals, etc. This is also stressed in livestock and dairy cow diets. See livestock production and dairy production videos.
In aquaculture, there is also the issue of biotechnology. Biotechnology is defined by the dictionary as the exploitation of biological processes for industrial and other purposes, especially the genetic manipulation of microorganisms for the production of antibiotics, hormones, etc. Biotechnology can, in some ways, revolutionize aquaculture with its ability to manipulate microorganisms and their hormones, which is a plus for many scientists. On the other hand, the definition clearly states that it involves genetic manipulation and the exploitation of biological processes, which could be considered unnatural or cause reduced biodiversity. That's all for today. Check out our latest video, and don't forget to hit the like button.